Hello, welcome to the new episode on how it works. On this video, I will explain to you a little bit more on how an MPPT is working and why it's needed. If you have a solar panel and you want to connect it to your battery, you need a charge controller. If you don't do this, you have the chance that your solar panel will overcharge your battery, and for certain you will not get the right amount of energy which is available from your panel into your battery. The MPPT Solar Charge Controller will make sure you get the most from your solar panel. So how does that work? Well, basically, the solar panel has two extreme options. The first one is if you don't load the solar panel at all. Then you have a quite high voltage, called the open clamp voltage, but you don't have any current, so there is no power. The other extreme is that the two cables are being short-circuited, so that you have a high current, but you don't have voltage, so then again, you don't have any power. The optimum is in between those two. So basically what a charge controller is doing is finding the optimum between a short circuit and not loading a solar panel. It all depends on the amount of solar energy you get from the sun, the amount of irradiation, but also the angle of the sun. And of course the amount of energy you need to charge your batteries. The MPPT charge controller is effectively looking for the highest sum between volts and current. If that sum is the highest, then you have the maximum amount of power, the maximum power point. What you see here is a typical solar panel, and it consists about a number of cells. Each cell, when radiated by the sun, is able to produce about half of a volt, and all these cells in series produce, on a 12 volt panel, about 17 volts, which of course typically that is too much to charge a 12 volt battery. Therefore you need a regulator to get it to the right level for your battery, but also you want to have the optimal energy from the solar panel towards your battery. That's what a charge controller will do for you. So typically there are two families of charge regulators. You have the PWM family and you have the MPPT charge controller family. What the PWM charge controller does, it limits the amount of voltage that you want to have on your battery. So that means if the voltage goes too high, it will just switch and switch off, that it avoids that the battery will be overloaded. The problem with that is that the PWM is not able to get the maximum amount of energy from that panel to your battery, because it could well be that maximum power point, the balance between a short circuit and an open clamp voltage, is at a higher voltage than what you actually would need on your battery, especially of course when you have serial connected panels. The MPPT instead will convert the energy from the solar panel into a voltage and converts that energy again to the energy needed for your battery. That means that the battery charge voltage is not related to the voltage you get from your panels. So it's much easier to have a serial connected system of solar panels and therefore get a longer charge day. So typically an MPPT charge controller is able to generate more energy from your panels than a PWM charge controller can do. There's another advantage also, because when you have an MPPT charge controller, you can work with a much higher PV voltage. That means if the PV voltage gets higher than your battery voltage, you can start charging. So having more parallels in series, that means the charging day will start earlier in the morning than if you would have a different configuration. The same would be at the end of the day, because with an MPPT and a high voltage from your panels, also the charging will go on longer in the afternoon. On this charge controller, you will see two sets of terminals. One is for the battery and one is for the PV. The PV and the battery have a common neutral. That means the solar panel will be connected, and on the solar panel the plus will go to the high side FET. The high side FET is a switch connected to a coil, and it will allow the energy from that solar panel into that coil. As soon as that coil is magnetized, the switch on the high FET will open and on the low side will close, allowing the energy to flow to the battery. By doing this, you have an optimum energy flow from your solar panel to your battery without any losses, almost nothing basically. A charge controller like this has an efficiency of maximum 97%. So basically, all the energy is harvested from the panels will travel to your battery without any significant losses. Sometimes you get a question why the MPPT charge controller is only active when the PV voltage is 5 volt higher than the battery voltage. Well, that has a reason. Because the PV voltage of a panel will lower as soon as you start loading it. So if you start the MPPT charge controller too soon, it means it takes energy to run, but is not able to take energy from your solar panel. So effectively, you will drain your batteries. So the MPPT charge controller will only be active if it sees a PV voltage which is so high that it effectively can charge the batteries without running and draining the batteries. This also implicates that the higher the PV voltage is, the sooner the MPPT charge controller will start working. So effectively, if you have more panels in series, so you start off with a higher voltage, the sooner the charge controller will be able to charge your batteries, and also the longer it will last during the day. Over here, you can see the terminals for the CAN ports, and the CAN ports can be used to connect the MPPT charge controller to a device such as a servo. By doing that, you can allow an external control in charging your batteries. So with DVCC, a multi or a quattro can instruct the MPPT what the maximum charge current or maximum charge voltage would be for your battery. What you also find here is the remote control, so you can switch the unit remotely on-off using a positive signal, a negative signal or a potential free switch. And of course there's the alarm relay to start and stop things based on battery voltage or state of charge. If you need more information on this product, please leave a comment and we will get back to you.